Tim, how important was what Lucas did yesterday? I know you, I think it was during the playoffs, you called it bully stage or something with kind of that dominant mode that he gets into. Was that something that was familiar to you yesterday?
Yeah, definitely. You know, the way that he competes on the mound, he gave us what we got. And, you know, I've been playing behind him for a while. And, you know, when he goes in that stage, you just know, you can see it. And that's something I saw. And, you know, you guys saw it as well. So, you know, that was a heck of a job by him. And, you know, hopefully he can continue to build off that and, you know, keep throughout the season.
You guys obviously have a few starting pitchers that are capable of turning in a performance like that. What does it do for a team in general when a starting pitcher can come in and kind of be, you know, I know it was just one loss, but be a stopper and kind of turn the momentum around for you guys?
No, definitely, you know, huge for us. You know, the offense is not going to always put up, you know, the crazy numbers that we did, you know, the couple nights before. And, you know, sometimes we're going to need those close run games. And, you know, that's something that they did. Kudos to him and, you know, the rest of the staff as well, you know, for shutting them down and, you know, leaving out there with a win.
Hey, Tim, you guys are 14-2 after losses this year. What does that say about how you guys are responding after a loss? You're not letting losing streaks happen and you're nipping them in the bud after usually one loss.
Yeah, they don't feel good. You know, losses don't feel good. And, you know, we just try to correct what we did the night before, you know, wrong and try to, you know, make it right. And try to, you know, continue to keep building. And, you know, as you know, that's really what's showing. You know, we're showing up to the ballpark every day ready to play. And, you know, the ultimate goal is to get a win. So, you know, that's what we're trying to do.
And one more question. What was it like dressing up like Moncada?
It was pretty dope. I'm going to have to put it in my, you know, my regular wardrobe.
What was that like for the team to get behind that and just so much? It seemed like every player was dressed like Moncada.
Yeah, that says a lot. We all bought in. You know, we all pulling from the same screen. We all get it. And there's no secret, you know, what we're trying to do. And, you know, that says one thing, that we're all in.
Jared raised out.
Hi, Tim.
How we doing?
Okay. What's it like for you and the White Sox to be in first place walking into Yankee Stadium and being able to play there on top of the league?
It's good. Being in a good spot. You know, definitely a confidence builder. We're going to treat these guys like, you know, anybody else. You know, just a different ballpark. So we're going to go out tonight and see, you know, see what happens. Give it everything we got and, you know, try to win a series.
Is there some sort of extra oomph to want to be able to beat the Yankees in New York?
No, we didn't do it before. So, you know, we just go about it the same way. And, you know, they're no different from anybody else. They put their pants on just like we do. They're human too. So, but we're gonna definitely try to go out and you know, get a win.
Thank you.
James speaking.
Tim, what was your read on Yermin and, you know, some of the criticism you faced and also for swinging 3-0 and also the Twins, you know, throwing at him?
Yeah, I mean, that's normal. You know, everybody gonna have a opinion. You know, for the Twins throw him, is definitely, you know, showing a sign of weakness. But I mean, you got a guy that's been playing real well. You know, he didn't know better in that situation. You know, so there's really no right or wrong. But I think the biggest thing is really, you know, keep building his confidence. You know, that's not a spot to really crush him. So, you know, just really show support towards him, because at the end of the day, it's really about, you know, us. We're trying to win. And you know, that's really about it.
You mentioned, you know, he didn't really know about the situation. Do you view it as a situation where you should hold back, or do you support him kind of doing what he wants in that situation?
It's fair game. If you don't want nobody to hit a home run off, you don't get on the mound or throw a pitcher. But, you know, like I said, that was definitely a sign of weakness from, you know, from Duffy and, you know, the Twins.
Anything else for Tim?
Billy, I got one. I don't know what's up with the hand raise function for me, but hey, Tim, real quick. Mm-hmm. You know, there's always so much talk when people go to Yankee Stadium that, hey, we're playing the Yankees, like trying to put it to the Yankees. But is it time for people to start talking about the White Sox?
Yeah, they should. But, you know, we used to be an underdogs. You know, they don't really have to talk about us. We're just going to continue to keep playing and, you know, keep proving people wrong and you know, keep taking care of us and our business. And, you know, the moment's never too big. So we just got to keep playing and, you know, keep having fun. And it's all about the last man standing. You know, that's the biggest thing. You know, it's easy to, you know, talk about it, you know, along in the middle of it. So, but we definitely want to be the last man standing. So we just got to keep pushing and who cares if they talk about us or not. We, you know, we just got to, we got to go out and get wins.
Come on, Bob.
Hey, Tim, a couple things. First off, did you get the chance to check out the big photo of you downtown New York here?
Oh, I've seen it, but I haven't went and checked it out, but I've seen it. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
And then just a separate subject, as far as just at the plate, just how are you feeling at the plate?
I feel good overall. Tonight's definitely going to be a huge series. I'm ready. I'm excited. So we'll see what happens. You know, nothing really changed. Confidence still there. And I'll show you. I'll show you.
Scott American.
Hey, Tim. Lucas, pretty matter-of-factly, I think, during spring training said, you guys are a good team. You believe you're a good team. You've known it since, you know, maybe even before spring training. And I think you've said something along that lines, too, during spring training. During the season. Is that how you guys play every day? Do you have, for lack of a better word, that matter about you guys every day?
Yeah. You know what you got. You know what you can do. So at that point, really just going out and playing. And, you know, man, we know these guys. You know, we've been playing with each other for a while, and we all know what we can do. And our confidence is up. We've been playing pretty good, and we've just been, you know, being great teammates and picking one another up. So we just got to continue to keep pushing and, you know, try to be that last man standing. And we got a chance to do that.
I'm sorry. We haven't talked much about the rebuild lately, but does it make a difference when you guys, you know, you came up together, you developed together, you lost together, and now you guys, you could see this forming even before it started last year, I would think.
Yeah. The bond's already there. You know, the bond's meshed. Everybody gets along. You know, at that point, you can really say anything to anybody. Nobody cares. You know, we all, you know, we've been in a struggling point together, and we all here now. So we just got to continue to keep pushing. And, you know, we know each other, and we just got to keep rallying around each other, and we'll be just fine.
Tim, you guys are in first place. You have the best team in the American League. You guys play hard every night. What is there a big deal whether or not everybody agrees on all the rules or unwritten rules? Is that a big deal in our world, or does it make a difference for you guys?
No, it don't matter. Everybody got opinion, and it don't matter. You know, we know what we like to do. We like to have fun. And, you know, we're trying to really worry about, you know, the outside world and just take care of what's in the locker room. And at the end of the day, you know, we're going to go out and play, you know, the way that we want to play. and then we're going to enjoy it and have fun with it. And that's how we're at our best. We're enjoying the game. And, you know, so we really don't really worry about, you know, the outside noise. We just take care and control what we can control.
So if you have a difference of opinion with your manager or your main does, yeah. It's not the end of the world, right? I mean, it's okay to have your opinion.
We're not going to always agree, and that's okay, you know, but we just keep moving and keep pushing. And he knows that, you know, we're not going to always be on the same page. But at the end of the day, we all got to go out and get a win, and we got to keep pushing. And so it's all good. It's okay to not, you know, to disagree from each other, but we all definitely pull from the same screen.
Thanks, Peter.
I mean, is this most recent situation where a disagreement has to be talked out to be able to move on with it? And have you guys been able to talk about that?
Yeah, we touched on it. But, you know, we try not to spend too much time on it. We let you guys talk about it. And as you see, you know, the media talk about it. But for us, you know, man, it's okay. You know, Tony's like that dad. We like his kids. We like the bad kids that don't listen. But we all get along. So we're just going to keep pushing, man. And he knows, man, we're going to go out and play and just have fun. And, you know, the ultimate goal is to get wins and, you know, enjoy the game. And, you know, hopefully we can just, you know, keep pushing and, you know, move on past this.
Billy Hamilton has said that since the moment he got there that you were big on, you know, hyping him up and telling him that he can hit and, you know, kind of give him confidence. Why did you guys connect so quickly? Why did you take that role to encourage him?
No, because you know the knack been on him that he just steals bases, and you know he got to realize how dangerous he can be in this game if he learns to hit. you know, his defense is there. He steals bases, you know, really, you know, all angles. And, that's kind of the way I go about it. So it's only right to, you know, share, you know, as much game as much as I'd learn to him. And, you know, build his confidence because, you know, that's how you're going to get the best out of him. And as you guys have been seeing, man, he's just been enjoying, you know, every moment of it. And, you know, he's made some huge defensive plays for us and, you know, stole a few bags. And also, you know, he's been hitting as well.
Darryl? Tim, you remember when Tony was hired, there was so much concern about him having been away from the game for a while and how he might mesh or blend with somebody like you, likes to have fun. What's it been like a month and a half, or what are we in, middle of late May now? How would you say the clubhouse is, the level of respect and the whole team unity thing? How would you?
Yeah, it's really, you know, it's really just noise, you know, for that goes for people that don't really know me, you know, for me not to get along with them. I get along with everybody. And, you know, the clubhouse is great. You know, everybody's happy. Everybody's enjoying the moment. And, you know, like I said, the ultimate goal is to get wins. And I think everybody's really pulling from the same string. Everybody gets along. You know, regardless of what, you know, Tony said to the media, he's still our manager. We're getting along just fine. So he's going to put us in the best, you know, best position to be successful. And, you know, that's what he's been doing. And, you know, hopefully we can just, you know, continue to keep pushing and, you know, keep rallying around one another. And, you know, keep the media out of our locker room.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you, guys.
Ha ha ha.